How blood clots form. Deep vein thrombosis, commonly referred to as DVT, occurs when a blood clot or thrombus develops in the large and deep veins of the legs or pelvic area. Some DVTs may cause no pain or swelling, whereas others can be quite painful and result in a lot of swelling. With prompt diagnosis and treatment, the majority of DVTs are not life-threatening. However, some can be an immediate threat to your life, especially a blood clot that forms in the invisible, deep veins, as compared to a clot that forms in the visible, superficial veins, the ones beneath your skin. A clot that forms in the large, deep veins is more likely to break free and travel through the vein. It is then called an embolus. When an embolus travels from the legs or pelvic areas and lodges in a lung artery, the condition is known as a pulmonary embolism, or PE. A potentially fatal condition if not immediately diagnosed and treated. What are the causes of DVT? Generally, a DVT is caused by a combination of two or three underlying conditions. Sluggish blood flow through a deep vein. This can be from immobility due to bed rest, surgery, or hospitalization. A tendency for a person's blood to clot quickly, which may occur due to genetics or cancer. Irritation or inflammation of the inner lining of the vein, which can be due to IVs. Symptoms of DVT and PE can develop slowly or suddenly. If you have any of these symptoms, contact your doctor immediately. Recent swelling of one leg. Unexplained pain or tenderness of one leg. Skin that is warm to the touch. Change in color, blue, red, or very pale. Symptoms of possible PE. Recent or sudden shortness of breath. Sharp chest pain, especially when breathing in. Coughing up blood. Sudden collapse. A feeling of apprehension. Risk factors for DVT and PE include recent major surgery, cancer and its treatment, major trauma or injuries to the leg, previous DVT or PE, hospitalization with an acute medical illness, recent immobility, pregnancy, use of the birth control pill or hormone replacement therapy, a family history of DVT or PE, obesity. How are blood clots treated? Both DVT and PE are treated with anticoagulants, which are sometimes called blood thinners. Anticoagulants decrease the blood's ability to clot to a controlled degree. While the body dissolves the clot, anticoagulants stop clots from getting bigger and prevent new clots from forming. Compression stockings may be prescribed to reduce the long-term pain and swelling that may result from vein valve damage or remaining clot or scar tissue. What can be done to prevent clots? Stay active. Don't smoke or stop smoking if you do. Maintain a normal body weight. In the hospital, the risk of blood clots in hospitals can generally be prevented with low doses of an anticoagulant or with the use of compression pumps. Be sure to discuss the prevention of blood clots with your doctor before elective surgery. Tell your healthcare providers that you want them to prevent the development of blood clots. Move your legs often and walk frequently if this is possible. Report any unexplained chest or leg symptoms to staff. For more information, visit the Vascular Disease Foundation online at www.vdf.org.